Helicopters have been around since the 40s, but it really hasn't been since the 70s that we've seen any significant development in the market. It's become quite stagnant. So why is Hill making a carbon airframe? Why differ away from something that has been an industry standard for the last 40 years?
So if you want to make a helicopter that's fast, then it has to be streamlined to be able to keep the drag to an absolute minimum. If you want to make a helicopter that has great payload and great hover performance, then it has to be light so that you've got the maximum payload available for the rotor system. And if you want to make a helicopter that's cost effective to manufacture and to own and operate, then you need to deliver all of those things with a very cost effective process. And that's why we use carbon fiber. Carbon fiber and molding techniques allow us to create a fantastic streamlined body using low cost, simple molds, patterns and tools. And then carbon fiber itself is an incredible material that is stronger than steel and about half the weight of the same amount of aluminium. So we can do wonderful things with the structural design, not just in terms of the shapes and the integrated load paths that we can design, but also in the fact that the material itself is so strong, so stiff, and so light. And then the clever part of all of this is moving away from traditional composite manufacturing methods where we required expensive material grades, expensive infrastructure such as autoclaves and expensive types of tools that could withstand very high temperatures, into more commodity based processes used in other industries that allow us to come out of the autoclave and to use lower cost patterns, molds, and tools that allow and lower cost raw materials that allow us to deliver all of the performance of composites, but at a price point that makes it viable for general aviation. So that's all well and good, but of course, to deliver those things, you've got to develop every single stage of the process and every little piece of infrastructure to be able to deliver those things. So over the course of the past 6 months or so, we've gone from an empty facility to a facility where we can manufacture our own patterns, manufacture our own low-cost molds, and then ultimately manufacture our own airframes in aerospace-grade materials, but at a price point that general aviation can withstand. We're currently building airframe 4, which is the first airframe that will bring together the outer skin that you can see behind me, the foam, the structural foam cores that make the internal structural details, and then the metallic inserts that connect all of the mechanical parts of the helicopter to the carbon fuselage. And we're now at a point where we can resolve all of the edge details that we need to create the recesses for the doors and create a beautiful flush exterior. We're getting good composite material out of the process, so all of the fibers are being, the infusion itself is working properly, all the fibers are being properly wetted out, and the material that we're producing as we produce the airframe is good quality composite material. And then we're refining and serializing the production methods to be able to produce these things quickly and cost effectively in high numbers.
Industrial revolution depends on the implementation and adaptation of skills from many different sectors. The HX50 is the embodiment of this. With years of potential sitting at the doorstep of aviation, now is the time to make dreams a reality. The HX50 is not just an aircraft that will revive general aviation, but one that will unite the community.